Howdy folks, in this video, I'll be compiling another tier list. This time, I'll be ranking takedowns, anywhere from S tier to just pulling guard. This curated list is compiled of a series of shots, throws, and other common techniques used to gain a dominant top position. Starting off with arm drags. Arm drags involve grabbing and pulling the opponent's arm across their body to imbalance them and set up for a takedown. This is a great, quick, and easy way to expose the back of your opponent. At the same time, it's a safe move to attempt. A pretty solid choice if you're dog shit at shots or throws. A tier. Next up, we got ankle picks. Ankle picks involve grabbing the opponent's ankle and lifting it whilst at the same time pulling their head down. I will say this is not the most effective takedown, especially if it's not set up correctly and is difficult to hit on plus-sized meatball female models. C tier. Next up, we got the Osotogari. This is a leg reap technique that involves sweeping the opponent's leg to the ground, resulting in them getting taken down. It's a pretty solid throw if you're familiar with judo. However, I'm not, so B tier. Next up, we got the double leg takedown. This involves you shooting in and grabbing both legs of your opponent to take them to the ground. Now, I know there's a ton of variations, but one in particular is especially horrible and has had a lasting impression with me, the blast double. I remember long ago when I was a young lad, we were drilling blast doubles at my club wrestling practice, and every time my opponent shot, I kid you not, the wind got blown out of me. Obviously, afterward, I went to my dad and I cried, begging to quit. He didn't let me. S tier. Next up, we got the headlock. The headlock involves wrapping the arm around your opponent's head and using it to throw them to the ground. This is typically one of the first throws you learn, and for that, it's typically one of the first throws you learn the counter to. So it's not super successful. However, it's pretty fun to hit when you get the chance to. Again, not super successful. A lot of people know the defense to this move. F tier. Next up, we got the fireman's carry. This involves lifting your opponent over your shoulder and carrying them to the ground. Pimenta is absolutely goaded at this move. However, I'm not. So it's a, middle of the road B tier. Following that, we have the collar drag. This involves grabbing your opponent's collar and or shoulder and pulling them to the ground while changing angles. Another super low risk takedown to attempt. I just find oftentimes that it requires a particular reaction from your opponent to work. C tier. Next up, we got the hip throw, or a hip toss, as others would say. A hip toss technique uses pretty much the hip as a fulcrum to throw your opponent over. I will say any throw that requires you to use your hips to jack up your opponent is just a spectacle to watch. There's tons of kind of variations of hip tosses, but I don't know. Something about it. A tier. Following the hip throw, we have the single leg takedown. It's a double leg, but now you got one leg instead of two. I'm just gonna go ahead and put this in the A tier category. Next up, we got snap downs. This involves controlling your opponent's top part of their head and thrusting it down to a front headlock position where you can circle to the back or shuck them by. Another really good takedown for those who absolutely are dog shit at shots and or throws. Something to note, if you've ever gone against a high level college wrestler, then you know the pain of getting snapped down so hard your face bounces off the floor like a basketball. Let me know if you feel my pain. A tier. Following snap downs, we have the scissor takedown. This involves sweeping your opponent's legs with a scissoring motion, both front side and back side, to imbalance them and take them down. Now, I do think this is a pretty effective technique. It's just not allowed at most competitions, and for obvious reasons, people always blow out their, knees from people attempting this. Just because it's not allowed at many competitions, I'm going to put this in the F tier category. Next up, we got the Uchimata. This is another hip throw that involves lifting your opponent's leg, sweeping it in a circular motion to throw them. That's really a great counter for anyone that's either chasing the back or on a low single or just a normal single leg. I will say I'm putting it in C tier just because oftentimes when this is hit, you let your opponent get deep on a single or deep chasing your back. Next up, we got the high single leg. This is just a single leg variation that involves grabbing a single leg and lifting it high in the air, close to the hip. Tons of variations of finishes on this. However, I do think it has a super high success rate. I'm gonna go S tier on this one. Next up, we got sacrifice throws. This is pretty much just where you drop to your back with the intent of throwing your opponent over your back and kind of doing a side roll or backwards roll to finish on top. Now, sacrifice throws look cool as shit. I just am not the biggest fan of dropping to your ass to throw someone over you. I think it has a low percentage chance of working, especially if your opponent takes one step backwards. That's all they gotta do, really. Next up, we got the flying squirrel. This involves launching yourself off the mat. Pretty much you need a 50-inch vertical to hit this, wrapping your body around your opponent to take them down. If you can hit this, kudos, but I'm pretty sure 95% of people aren't Michael Jordan, so I think it's a pretty dog shit takedown to go for. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it in the F tier. Yeah, here's another one of my videos to enjoy.